Hey, good evening. I just wanted to share something for the young people among us. The general rule for people over the age of, I want to say 31 for Social Security disability, is that they have to have earned 20 earnings credits. Those are those Social Security credits we talk about elsewhere, 20 of them in the last 10 years. But when we're under 31, obviously there's a recognition that you didn't really have that many years in which to earn 20 credits. So what it ends up being is, and I'm going to talk about first the 24-year-old. If you are 24 or less, you can qualify for Social Security disability if you worked a little bit in your past and if you earned 6 credits in the 3 years prior. So if you are 24, you're going to look at the exact 3 years prior and see if there are 6 credits earned in there. This can happen on extremely part-time work, as long as it's tax paying. So don't assume because you're young, you could not have earned enough for Social Security disability. It is not the same as retirement. To get retirement, we all have to have earned our 40. So it's definitely different. And if you happen to be over 24, but under 31, you're gonna have to earn half of the credits between the age of 21 and the time your disability began. So if you're 25, say, that's 4 years, and it would go by year, by quarter, really. So while you could have earned in 4 years, 4 times 4 is 16, you need only have earned 8 to be insured. And if you can prove that you were disabled at the time, you're checking to see if you're insured. So it's kind of a moving target. So if you were 28, it would be the 7 years between 20 and 20, 21 and 28, 6 years. The full amount of credits one can earn is 24, but you only needed to earn 12. Okay. So that really helps out for people who are starting out, didn't have the opportunity to have a really robust work history. Now, mind you, your benefit level will be related specifically once you've found out that you're insured at the time you claim and then prove you were disabled. The amount of benefit you will get is going to be directly related to how much you paid in. So if you obviously if you worked more, paid in more, you're going to have it's like paying for premiums. You're going to have a higher insurance benefit as a result due to the higher premium you paid, as a general rule, of course. But I hope that helps. I am working on a 22-year-old case right now, soon to be 23. So, and I just received her Social Security earnings statement, which you can all get at ssa.gov/my account when you check into your own personal account with the SSA. You're going to want to, if you think you're disabled and unable to work full time at any job, and mind you, if you work part time, you could still potentially file for disability. I have a video on that too. So you want to look at those. But if you're not working at all, let's just make it the flat out easy scenario. Download your Social Security earnings statement from the ssa.gov/my account after you connect yourself and identify yourself with them. And that's going to tell you how much you've earned that they have record of Social Security earnings. And from there, when you find out what the cost of a credit is, you can do the math and figure out how many you have earned in each of those years. And then you can look at those years and look at that 3 year back window, or maybe you have a 4 year back window, whatever, depending on your age, like we're talking about. And what's nice about it is generally that if you're insured today, and you have to do the math on this and the charting out of the numbers we're talking about, it's not just today that you're disabled. Let's say you can't prove that you were disabled today, but the medical evidence starts piling in 6 months from now because you finally started getting treatment. You may still be insured because there is a window, but you'll do the math as of that time. So there is always something called a date last insured. Once we stop working, that thing becomes solid. So to find out your date last insured, which means all the evidence before then is what you're going to use to prove you're disabled while you still treat, though, after that date, you can find out your date last insured by calling 1-800-772-1213. And once you get a live body on the phone, and that can take a little bit of a wait, so I suggest you plug in your phone, put it on the speaker, or put your headphones in, go about your business. And then when someone comes on the line, you ask for your date last insured. If you have never worked and paid taxes as such, you will not have a date last insured. You will never have become insured for Social Security disability. In that case, if you are poor, you can file potentially for SSI, which would have the same disability question that they have to work up to determine if you're disabled. But there is no requirement for having worked and paid in, as you would have for the Social Security disability insurance. Okay. Any questions? Just give me a holler. I'll try to get the link up to this page too. This is just an SSA page. It's easy to find if you just do a search for, I think, like earning credits under ssa.gov or something like that. Okay. All righty. Hope it helps. Bye.